So for today's walk, we're going to be, we're in the Banchak area, Banchak BTS. We're going to be walking down Sukhumvit Soi 97/1, and we're going to walk till we get to the very end of 97/1, and then we're going to take a left. And after we take a left, we're going to head down Sukhumvit Soi 93, and I'll walk down there to the very end. Once I get to the very end, I'll do a U-turn and then come back all the way back down 93 until I get back to Sukhumvit Road, and we'll finish at the BTS Banchak. Now, this is a really good area. Be a good area to live because it's just a little bit outside of the main city center, so you get that more local character, kind of local feel to the area. When you're outside of the city a little bit, the prices are a little bit lower, so restaurants are more affordable, and you get a bit more local cuisine, cuisine that is aimed at locals rather than the foreigners or the tourists or the city slickers. It's also a good location because you're very close to the BTS, so if you're close to the BTS you can get yourself to the city pretty easily and avoid traffic jams. Also, just behind me is Soi, Sukhumvit Soi 62. Now, Soi 62 is a road that leads down to the main highway, one of the major tollways, the S1 section of the tollway. So it's very easy to get to the main highway to get out of town. So if you're traveling anywhere outside of the city, you've got quick access. So this is a very good place. Now, as you'll see as we go down the streets, we've got a lot of character, plenty of restaurants, plenty of cafes along the way. And I hope you enjoy the walk. So here is Banchak BTS station, and just over opposite there we've got Soi 62, which leads to the main highway, as I mentioned before. And we're actually starting here at Soi 99. The reason I'm starting at Soi 99 is I could find a nice little park for my red Vespa. There's a big Jets here on the corner, and also there's a couple of guest houses. So if you're a backpacker looking for a hostel, this would be a great little spot here. Okay, walking down main road Sukhumvit here, so it'll probably be pretty noisy. Drinks, snacks, foods, and it's called Banchak Square. The big Japanese restaurant inside. And at the moment, COVID restrictions, there's no dining in allowed, so that's why there's nobody there. But it's a great place to get some food once you get off the BTS. Okay, we're gonna walk down 97/1. It's also known as Soi Sang Thawan. As with every BTS station, easy to find motorcycle taxis. A great way to get around town, cheap and fast. Because because they can weave through all the traffic and not get stuck in any traffic jams. This is always a problem in any major big city. Hostels, bed and breakfasts. There is At Ban Chuk, nice yellow building there. I love the colourful townhouses. These townhouses, three-storey or four-storey, are very common around these parts of Thailand. They've got the cafe down the bottom floor for foot massage, whatever their line of business is on the ground floor. Restaurant, khao soi place, and I love khao soi. Khao soi place, and then the living up above. The ground floor is usually floor space about 30 square meters. So if you've got three levels of 30 square meters, 90 square meters of shop and living quarters. And then we've got accounting offices. A lot of character, these places, I think. And I've seen a few that have been preserved, renovated, and that look really cool. Going right for something like that, about somewhere between, and if it's this close to a BTS, somewhere about 8 to 10 million. Four stories, of course, go a little bit more expensive than a three story. Motorcycle rather, giving me the forks, or the back that's peace sign, or the bunny ears. Yeah, for the townhouse, three-story, four-story, if you're outside of town, away from Sukhumvit, away from BTS, 2 million, you get one for. They're usually always fixer-uppers, though. Turbo kicking in. Delivery vans. Inside of Bangkok, there's no trucks allowed, no heavy vehicles. So therefore the heavy vehicles have to stop on the outside of the town, and then it's those delivery vans that do all the deliveries inside of town. And surprise, surprise, those guys, worst drivers, always in a rush, always grumpy because they're being on the road all day. So if you see one on the road, get out of their way. Be on a bike, see a delivery driver, get well away. Second traffic to avoid are these big pickup trucks. Certain attitude with pickup truck drivers, particularly the brand new flash pickup trucks. How do I say? They think they're a little bit better than everybody else, so they don't. The rules don't apply to them. And poor old motorcycle riders or cyclists, pedestrians, or if you're driving your old Corolla around, yeah, it doesn't seem to matter. Of course, these are generalizations. It's based on over a year of driving around Thailand. Generally speaking, Thai drivers are very polite and considerate. For example, if you're about to enter a street and somebody else is entering at the same time, quite often they'll yield and wave you in. Quite polite. Much more polite than other countries I've been, where it's me first, me first. The Thai drivers and people in general are very quite polite and considerate. So while driving is a bit chaotic, the traffic's chaotic, Thai politeness shines through time and time again. here. When there's no traffic around, the road's nice and smooth. It's a nice concrete road. No great obstacles, which screams out, please open me up, screams the bike. Yes, but unfortunately, most of that, those big bikes just get stuck in traffic jam, especially around on that Sukhumvit road. So big bikes, big motors, people love them, but sure if they're not sure if they're the best option here in Thailand, in the big city, in the big smoke. The Clip Barbershop, I like the style there. I like it a lot. It's nice corrugated iron. Gentleman's haircut, place like that, usually about 100 baht, 150, something like that. If you only have English, you may struggle a little bit, but handy when you've got a phone and you can say, that's what I want to look like. I don't want to look like Neymar, I want to look like Beckham. I look like one of the BTS members. Often the barbers have pictures on the wall as well, and I often find myself just pointing to a picture on the wall and give me that one, please, madam, please, sir. Spirit House. This is a, I think it's a 4-star hotel. Just on the little Klong, the little river here, the little creek. Yeah, 4-star hotel it is. Excellent reviews, not a bad location. Prices are good, about just over 1,000 baht currently for a room. Doesn't look great from my angle, but from the distance it looks good. Here we go. I like the look of this. Cat versus dog. Some old houses. Interesting around these streets here. Quite often it's never just a house, it's a house and the family business. The old Kawasaki, the quacker. Cool colour. These three-story renovated townhouses. As I mentioned, a fixer-upper, so someone's really done a wonderful job there. And again, the shop storefront down the bottom, living quarters up above. I like what they've done. A laundry shop going in there. Oh, look at the colour on this place. Beautiful colour scheme. He's outstanding. For rent. A little pizza shop down the bottom there. A little up top. So for when people are getting their laundry done, come over and get one of Luke's pizzas. Nicely renovated place. Just see if I can get a picture of it. Oh, a bit too close. Get a bit further away. White theme. Place still under construction. Yes. Actually getting painted at the moment. Yeah, I love these, the charm of these townhouses. There's the other side of it. So I love this juxtaposition of the old next to the new. Get a lot of that here in Bangkok. Vines here look lovely. The root system, one of the vines, but it's actually a parasite. This, these vines here, they can sneak inside of under paint, cracks in walls. Once they get into the crack of a wall, they'll expand and expand, and nature wins that battle. Motorcycle shop. Nice house. Okay, Zongba is quite popular, and that's down 97/146. Check out Zongba.
no time for a beer just now. Okay, so we've reached the end of 97/1. We're taking a left now. I'm going to keep walking until we get to 93. Once we get to Soy 93, we will take a right. Walk to the very end. Then head back. The Zong Bar back there, I'm not going, decided not to go because first of all it's not open daytime, so no one's going to be around. It's a little bit off the beaten track, but it's one of those cool kind of outdoor restaurant pub places. We have some live music and Premier League playing, delicious Thai food. One place I like to hang out at. Maybe another walking video. I can find the best pubs, restaurants, and take you on a tour. Very end of 93. At the end there's a school. Little shop houses there. Delicious, fresh, sweet. Little market space of some sort. Sukiyaki style. Now down here, Shabu Indy is quite a popular restaurant. Laundry bar, Taekwondo, 20 baht shop, a little market space. Yes, but Shabu Indy, popular when restaurants are open and dining is allowed. Here we go, vintage style, that's what I was talking about. Usually pictures on the wall so you can tell the barber what you want, which if you don't have English, I just point into the pictures on the wall. Basil 3249 looks good. There's some krapao. Thank you. converse machine used to be mum and dad shops used to do laundry, and they used to pay for it by the kilogram. Now they're being replaced by machines. Here we go, 24.3. So with the laundry business in Thailand, machine is one. And see, hardly ever see mum and dad, auntie and uncle shops anymore. Nice grey and orange colour scheme there. Yeah, auntie and uncle laundry shops anymore. It's coin operated machines nowadays. Sign of the times. Time, a great place to come, get some food. A very popular Suntam shop, that one. If that's your style. Spicy Thai salads. theme of this video, it seems. And neutering to street dogs. Let's see if I can get it on the way back. Point it out to you. PAWS, Paws, it's called. So if you're an animal lover, be sure to check them out. You're in the market for a pet cat, new kitten, puppy, before buying a dog, consider adopting Paws. And this, my friend, is the end of the story. This is Wat Rat Satatam, Satatam School. A local school and temple. School holidays at the moment, so there won't be any kids around. Arabic school and temple. We won't go in there today. Now this video is focusing on the street walks. In other videos, I will be going to temples. Won't do that today. So, U-turn, time to head back to Sukhumvit. Sukhumvit Road. So a bit of a gloomy day today. To adjust the white balance, but that's the actual color of the sky. Cafe. No restaurants open at the moment. It looks like a cool place to hang out if you like gardens. And like cafes. Bottom level, even somehow stuck a shipping container in the back there. I like what they've done there, but downstairs, the bottom floor, it's really special. And then upstairs, we'll get to that later. Character filled. So down this little side street, number 40, is where Hawes is. The animal adoption place. Just pop down there so you can find it while we're here in the neighborhood. Here it is. Okay, interestingly, you can see the gazebo, marquee, their tent set up down here. This is what they do when there's a funeral or a wedding. So that one looks like a wedding that they're either setting up for or what's happened. Is, was, used to be here. Not anymore. and check out the local market.
Thank you.
293 toward Bunchuk Sikkimbit Road. Yeah, this is a nice Italian restaurant, Navara Cucina, Italian and Thai restaurant. Nice setting. Burger Bomb, steak and burgers, $49. Gan Sushi is a good Japanese restaurant. I would recommend it. Food truck. This area here has got a few little neat little restaurants, cafes, restaurants. And a indoor footy field. Close to Sugarbit Road now, and to the end of our tour today. Let's see, by the height of the buildings, we're getting close to Sugarbit Road. If you ever get lost and you're down one of the soys, don't know which way to go, look for the buildings. Outlet here, Jim Thompson's, most famous Americans.